I've got your back no matter what.
Hey folks, Dave the Not-So-Evil, Evil Viking 13 here, and welcome back to Fallout 4 with Joel.
Thanks for having me, Dave.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. and it's time for my longest running Fallout 4 build. This is going to be the Minutemen's...
Slowest running.
You gotta have that slow walk.
Yeah.
And it's gonna be the Minutemen Castle. This is going to be the capital of the Minutemen. We've done some good in the Commonwealth, right? We've built up new towns, we've rescued people, we're there to help. The capital, the castle, is like the center of like just unnecessary fanciness to just impress the other factions in the Commonwealth. The Minutemen fell once. Now they're back under General Dave, and they're here to stay. And this is where we're just going to make our mark on the Commonwealth.
Man, I'm getting nervous.
Are you getting nervous,
Joel? Looking like I see a lot of those... The American type banner, the
bunting. They're bunting. Oh, yeah, okay. Yeah. The patriotic bunting.
What's that show on Netflix about the train? You like the show?
Oh yeah, yeah. Hell on Wheels.
Hell on Wheels. I feel like they have those.
The
like,
bunting
everywhere.
Yeah. Welcome to Fort Independence, the capital of the Minutemen. Now, Fort Independence is an actual fort in Boston, off the shore, and it actually was founded and built in 1864. But as you can see, we've made a few additions. A little bit of type there at the bottom, spray painted on top. Capital of the Minutemen. And let's just go ahead and wander past the sign here to the grand entrance. That makes a statement, one could say.
Oh, man.
So this is where you would come if you have, say, a meeting with the general. Maybe you're one of my settlement leaders, or you're wanting to trade with the Minutemen. This is where you come for
Did
your
you
appointment.
Did you enclose this?
Yes. This, if you look, was actually where one of the holes in the castle
was. I was like, I feel like there was a hole there on my aim.
And now it's a fancy entrance.
Oh my gosh.
Before we head up to the main entrance, though, let's check out the trading area. Now, not a lot of trade goes on with the rest of the Commonwealth from the castle. Again, the castle is kind of like, it's the capital. Like, if you're here, you should really have an appointment. But still, if you want to trade some basic armor and stuff like that, there is a trade area outside, along with...
You coldly answer, with hell.
We don't sell guns here, because that would be kind of dumb, selling guns right outside your capital.
I was curious.
We do sell cigarettes, though, because they're good for you.
I feel like this is like the tourist area, like, oh, look at that! Oh, we don't have tickets to actually go in, so you can get the trinkets here.
Exactly. Well, it's the tourist area, and then also the refugee area. Yeah.
Oh my god.
You can buy some armor here. Notice that everyone's kind of dressed up. You got to make a statement.
You hear about that farm run by ghouls? Isn't that something?
Join the Minutemen, rebuilding the American way of life.
Dave way of life.
Let the propaganda begin.
Oh my gosh.
And again, Joel, we've kind of created this kind of backstory, right? You were making some references back all the way in Sanctuary that Minutemen under General Dave was like just like a 10% fascist, like a
10%, yeah,
a little bit high of the propaganda.
It started all kind of like, oh, it's cute, like we have some posters just to kind of remind people, but now it's like, no, you will be reminded.
Here at the castle, I kind of embraced that theme. The Minutemen are still doing good in the Commonwealth. Don't get me wrong.
Yeah.
But we're gonna remind you that we're doing good and remind you that General Dave is in charge. Next to the front entrance, here were some vehicles wrecked during the Great War. We have a refugee area where people are kind of camping out, hoping to get into the castle. But again, if you're at the castle, you have to have an appointment. You have to be someone pretty important. This is not a settlement where you can just show up and, like, move in. So
I imagine the only reason you allow people to sleep here is because they're right across from buying stuff from
you. And, you know, I'm a kind general. There's plenty of turrets and defenses along the wall that this is a pretty safe place to stay for a while. Now, you stay here too long, I'll make sure that Sarge 2.0 makes sure that you move on.
Sure. Do not touch.
You remember Sarge from the castle, like, tunnels fight?
Oh, yeah.
He was the previous general's robot. Well, I've made Sarge 2.0. Yeah, like you said, do not touch.
I like the blue.
Yeah,
really cool.
He's armed with a Gatling laser and a Gatling rocket launcher, which just seems
unnecessary. Do you have everything unlocked to do that?
Yes.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, dude, I have all the building perks, as you might imagine. I
can't imagine. Like, do you have any perks left unlocked in the game?
Oh yeah, tons.
Still? Wow.
Because I've ranked up, like, starred a bunch of perks. In this refugee area, we got some people who are, like, staying in the bus. Looks like someone's been sneaking in some Pleasure Island propaganda. Pretty crappy place to sleep, like on a tilting bus. But you're under the watchful eyes of the Minutemen, so it's pretty safe. And then back here, there's an old APC from the war where someone's like dragged a sleeping bag or like a little mattress inside to sleep. But
I imagine when you're sleeping and like someone else comes in that way, and you hear the door shut, you're like, "What's that? Oh no!" I slept in the wrong place.
Should have locked that door. Not everyone's happy about being trapped outside of the castle, though.
More time.
But the entire main entrance here is just a tribute to the return of the Minutemen.
Ooh, that's a cool new statue.
Yeah. I've got a mod that lets me build a couple of extra statues.
Is that a legit statue, too? Or is that like a Fallout kind of
It's a Fallout
one?
Spin on one,
okay,
I think.
Because I know, obviously, they try to like capture the essence of Boston and a lot of that stuff, so I know some things are like pretty legit. That one just looks like, bring it on!
And as you can tell from down below, the biggest advantage of the castle's defenses are the fact that the walls are absolutely massive. Like, no one's going to be able to easily attack that. I'm walking in the water.
This place, it already kind of reminds me a little bit of, I think, Pirates of the Caribbean. When Jack Sparrow is like getting ready to get killed or hung or something like that,
yeah.
And escapes. It just reminds me of this, that kind of feel tone to it.
You'll also notice, Joel,
your FPS is low.
It's locked at 32. Like, I actually have it locked, and it stays at 30, but it's just not 60 anymore.
No.
You'll also notice that I'm not wearing my usual uniform. The general's uniform is like the traditional, like, historical one. This is the general's dress blues for the parade ground.
Like how you have, like, a American flag sash.
Yes. Yes, I do.
Like, it's probably bloody. Like, you probably strangled someone who was not going along with your rules.
Got shotgun turrets watching the entrance right here as we walk up. We have an automatic radiation cleanser as you enter the entranceway to the castle. And Preston Garvey's up there on the balcony watching over.
Oh my gosh.
Here we go. Welcome to the front entrance. This is where you check in if you have an appointment. And as you can see, Piper's currently manning the front desk. This is the center of opulence for the Minutemen. This is where people who arrive here are just wowed with the decadence.
This looks like the presidential address type area.
This is just the waiting room, Joel. This is just the waiting room.
One day. We'll see you guys, I'm leaving. Bad enough. Too much. Laser turrets or something?
Yes, we have minigun and laser bubble turrets in the ceiling to help cover the entrance. So if you somehow break in the secured steel doors out front, there's turrets in the waiting room to watch over you.
Wow.
Just a very pleasant set of paintings, and it's a very nice waiting area. Reminder of the past glory of the Minutemen. Nice view into the courtyard from the windows. One fun part about using mods to kind of create these super detailed interiors that are actually part of like the overall game world is that you have windows you can just look out of. Hmm. It destroys your frame rate, but it's kind of cool.
I like, it's a camera up there.
Did you notice the camera?
Yeah, I noticed the camera.
Which corner was it in? Oh yeah, there it is. Yeah. Control. Camera watching the entrance.
What are we going to find out?
That ties into a few areas, actually. Well played, Joel. I'm just going to scoot back here so we can see a little bit out into the courtyard. Got some radio to do those Minutemen background checks.
Yeah.
Some power controls for the lights and a nice American flag in the back. Also here for the front entrance, we have a quick access. Let me close the doors here. To the catwalk upstairs. This door is secured usually, but it does allow access to the rooftop from here.
That's cool.
Are you ready, Joel, to enter the castle itself, the courtyard?
Dude, I feel like now watching you build these, they remind me of like Dark Souls, where you go through it so far, and then all of a sudden you open a door and you're like, I'm back at the start. How did that happen? What amazing level design!
We're gonna come back around to a few things, actually.
Yeah, I'm ready.
Into the inner courtyard we go.
Open them doors wide.
The Minutemen rebuilding America.
Always remind me. of course.
Welcome to the Memorial Courtyard. This is where the eternal lantern is lit in memory of the Minutemen who have fallen before us, in honor of the previous generals, and the classic Minutemen. Joel, you look like you're in shock.
You embarrass Bethesda, I think. Like, you embarrass, because it's like, this instantly just looks way more interesting to explore than, like, 90%, I think, of Fallout 4's main levels. Like, besides maybe some swampy areas are kind of
cool.
Yeah. But, like, these just look so rich, like, they feel so interesting. I want to explore it. I think a lot of levels, even in Bethesda's games, like, I don't know, they're just like, okay, this is cool. This is a little city. But, like, this is, like, the bushes and stuff. Oh, my gosh.
Yes,
so cool.
I use an old mossy brick for the base of the outer deck. And this is kind of just like a memorial garden where you can pay tribute and just sit and reflect. Again, it's just like a symbol of the Minutemen's power. There's just some reminders of who's actually in charge here at the castle.
Subtle reminders.
Just some subtle reminders.
Bow the knee. General Dave. That's awesome. That's a really cool, actually, texture of what that...
Yeah.
Like, it looks very... almost like black tarp. I wish more
people could see. I'm gonna come up here.
Remind them what it's all about.
And we're
gonna
scoot down the deck just a bit. Got some nice benches here where you can overlook the courtyard if you want to. As we travel down the deck here, you can see that we've got a Nuka-Cola machine for our guests. Some fresh, cold...
Put a Nuka-Cola. Like, now, ever since I'm like, hey, there's no Nuka-Cola in there. Always a Nuka-Cola.
And a matching banner on this side. General Dave. Oh my gosh. And just in case you missed those
two...
Wait,
is that actually a photo of you, too?
It's a screenshot of my character at the castle.
Like, it just shows a little bit.
It's like a little like, stylized, like, half version of my face. And in case you somehow missed those banners, you got the one on the tower in the center.
I feel like you're turning into Dr. Breen from Half-Life 2. You
know, yeah, yeah.
Welcome to City 17. You have been chosen or will be chosen.
Oh, if you're here, you've been chosen, all right. General Dave fighting for a better future.
Oh, gosh.
In the center of the castle courtyard, we have the primary barracks. So I've added this additional barracks. And built it kind of like an old, like, 1940 style military barracks. You've got the bunk beds, you've got the foot lockers, and it's kind of just like an open hangout area in the center.
That's cool.
I believe I have most of the windows on a shutter system. Let me see if it's going to work.
A shutter system?
Yeah, it's hard to find the hotspot. There it goes.
Oh, wow, that's cool.
Secure shutters in case of an attack. Because a lot of the windows are blown out, too.
Do they all close?
Yes, they all close like that. I had to add the shutter for each window by hand. And again, for a build like this, even with all the opulence and the ridiculous amounts of just, you know...
Do you try to build the amount of beds for how many people are in there, too? Like, do you count?
Yes.
Wow. Okay.
Yeah. I'm also trying to build using things that, like, could actually be possibly looted, you know? So there's actually broken windows, and even for the nicer sections of the nicer brick... It's stuff that with enough time and forced labor, we could actually build this stuff.
Yeah.
Here in the back of the barracks, got kind of like a little lounge area. Someone's got a robot model kit right there.
Of course, no one actually has time off, but you have one there.
Yeah.
Facade of time.
Yeah. Notice how no one's actually in the lounge. Actually, I think
away.
Everyone but two people in this settlement out of the 28 in this settlement are all assigned to jobs. In the back here, we have the showers for the barracks. And all of this was built on top of the debris from the destroyed castle. So I fit everything into, like, the closest possible areas to make use of the open spaces between the debris. Got the sink, the shaving station, some shower stalls, the curtains. And then across the hall, close that door. I think these have, can't find the hot spot. They have sliding doors that are currently stuck open.
Oh, yeah, I see them.
Yeah.
That's cool, though.
You got the toilets back here.
That's really cool. I'm saying toilets are looking cool. Gosh.
I mean, it looks like an actual barracks bathroom.
Yeah, it does.
If small. Don't worry, though. There's plenty more bathrooms to come. And
a little ashtray. I just noticed that.
Yeah, oh, of course. And the board games and the
you
table.
Have, do you have a cigarette on it at all? Or does it come with one?
Not here. Everyone's cleaning up their cigarettes at this settlement because they know better. Because General Dave
spends
a lot of time.
No Nebula games
here.
Are allowed in this settlement.
Or are they? We'll have to see.
We're in the dungeons.
Even in the barracks. Even in the barracks, a reminder.
General Dave will never stop fighting. My gosh.
And this is actually based off of actual World War II propaganda. Originally, it was just the Statue of Liberty with the fire behind it, and it just said, never. And then it added, the General Dave will never stop fighting.
Listen to the wisdom of the past.
That brings us to the centerpiece of the courtyard, which is, of course, the radio tower, Radio Freedom. And it's been given a couple of upgrades. They are, in fact, on the
air
right now.
This is like the center where you have like the... Yeah, mine's literally, I think, a shack.
Yeah.
Mine's just a shack and open up and three generators hooked up to it. That's it.
This is the original shack right here. This is where he is broadcasting Minuteman Radio. And he actually has he has a special uniform. It's like a messenger uniform so he can get the messages out to the radio. And plenty of equipment and some stolen Institute equipment to help populate the radio station. And I know that people are going to wonder about stuff like the trees out here. Notice how young they are. We stole a lot of very nice technology from the Institute, at least in my playthrough, in the back of my mind.
In the back.
So you'll notice that we don't have any gigantic new trees, but we have the start of some new growth, even here in the Fallout universe. And speaking of stolen Institute technology, let's head over to the communications center, which is attached to the radio. This is where we...
Is that the beer guy?
Yes, it is. This is where we watch over the Commonwealth.
What in the world?
This is the comm center, where Detective Valentine is currently on station, keeping an eye on all of the stuff going on out there.
Those cameras don't actually attach, like, connect to anything, do they?
So yeah, basically all of the cameras out in the Commonwealth and here at the castle all connect here to the communications center.
What is that on there? Getting the drop on communists.
Getting the drop on communists. As you can see, they have the telephones for communicating around the castle itself, the radio for talking to other settlements and calling for help, and the cameras to watch over everything out there.
Getting the drop on communists by becoming communists.
And there's more cameras here in the comm center.
Everyone's being watched.
I'm watching the comm center, watching everyone else. Oh, and it looks like our second radio operator has been sneaking a comic book into his desk.
He's going to get flogged.
And there's all kinds of extra equipment.
Like, why do they have propaganda in here? Why do they, the people that actually work here need to, like, constantly reminded, if you call, we'll answer.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Of course. Of course, Joel.
Of course.
And all of the shutters in here can open and close for security, too.
That's cool. What's that? Sneeze nay.
Back here, we have the guard room for people on watch. If you're on watch for the day. And this is about as military as it gets. Just bare bones.
Yeah.
Order and
is this
structure.
Like rotation type room?
Basically, yeah. No real personal effects here, just military-style structure.
This makes me remind me of like semi-truck drivers that like, do cross-country and stuff, how the person will sleep in the back.
Yep. As we go out the back of the guard station here, you can see Buddy, who is offering us a drink, I believe. So we're going to pass on that for now. He's already been giving him out, it looks like, because there's beer all over the table.
I love that. I love that guy. It's funny.
Here, we're working on some Minuteman power armor to help protect your Commonwealth.
Did you add the texture on that armor?
It's a mod, and it looks really, really good. I love
that's
like the,
really cool.
The wear and tear, like the slight wear on the paint. I love how that texture looks. This is just kind of a work shed and a reminder for the Minuteman soldiers about the dangers of STDs. I mean,
it's lurking in the depths.
It's a castle full of soldiers. Like, you gotta be prepared.
And you. And maybe you too.
Syphilis, you and maybe you too. that's horrifying. And you can actually see where they've been painting the power armor blue.
That's pretty cool.
So, from the work table and the communication center, we're going to head to the most slightly fascist authoritarian section of the castle build, the parade field. This is where General Dave gives his addresses and speeches to the men to inspire them.
Oh my gosh. You have a cannon?
A historical cannon on the stage.
I imagine it's like fired like before you come up and then fired after you're done.
There's a bell here. Make them come out to the speech. They gotta gather up. Some bit of old world propaganda. Minutemen fighting for the freedom of America. And on the side of the parade field, just in case you've forgotten, a statue of General Dave the Hero. The flowing cape and the sword just gets me. And notice the spotlight up there on the bottom of the deck to make sure that it's always lit. And, you know, behind the stage, a reminder. Order is safety. Work together and we can rebuild. That's like the most Orwellian phrase I can think of. Order is safety. And there's a look at the parade field. We have a basketball hoop for some entertainment. Some bits of posters and all back here on the side of the parade field. We're all in this together. Hard work is happy work. More bunting. And a doghouse for the guard dog.
Of course.
With a warning sign. And a window to look into the radio station.
Just the amount of signs. Your place totally looks down on people like, hey, did you realize these are bathrooms? This is a barracks. It's like, in case you didn't realize after you got whipped and flogged and told several times. What's, oh my gosh, that guy's...
The guards here at the castle do not mess around. Huh? They have a combination of Minutemen armor and railroad armored plates with Gatling miniguns and Gatling lasers.
That guy is a beast.
And they all wear berets, because basically everyone who is stationed here at the castle is like the Minutemen Special Forces. Like, if you're stationed here, it's like the best promotion in the Commonwealth for the Minutemen.
You're the best of the best.
Yeah. Now, if you remember, Joel, the castle actually has like a water purifier outside at the ocean when you first get it. Mm-hmm. We still use that, but in case of an attack where we have to just lock things down and like hold out for reinforcements, if all of our Special Forces aren't enough, we have an internal well system to provide just tons of purified water the residents of the castle.
Wow.
And that's next to the staff exit back here.
Was that the... Did we go through that or no?
No, this is the staff exit / entrance.
Got turned around.
And again, turrets watching over everything.
Of course.
So we're actually going to head up the back stairs here.
I like how the turrets are kind of like really hard to reach, so
you
have to get like a ladder to fix them.
And additionally, you also can't use the turret platforms to climb any of the walls. They're just high enough where you can't get to them to climb them. On purpose. Here's all the water pumps and water purifiers back here. This thing moves some serious water, but it also connects to the back of the barracks here. It's a little side platform. Now, this section here in the back...
Oh, wait, turn to the door.
Yeah.
I was remembering this from earlier, and I wanted to see if you were going to match it, but I was looking at the lights.
Yeah.
And I was like, I wonder if Dave's going to have the exact same height above the door handle and the exact same height, too. Oh, my gosh. Like, I was just like, because it looks really legit. And I was like, I wonder if he's going to get the same or one's going to be higher or lower. Nope, exact.
Up here, this was actually, you can see it just a bit, this was all rubble in this back corner of the castle. This is the section of the wall that it was totally destroyed.
Dude, like, I have no idea where I'm at, like, in the real place, because it looks so different to me.
And we're actually going to zoom out and take a look at the original castle in just a second here, because this area right here was built section by section, aligned bit by bit, to cover up the rubble and provide, like, a nice... ornate series of steps up to the top.
Just posters everywhere. Yes. Ooh, a brick wall? More like room for another poster.
So I think now that we've seen some of the stuff in the courtyard, Joel, it's time to take a look at what we've added for this build. So let's just go ahead and I'm going to turn the UI back on.
Okay.
And I'm going to do a quick save so we can just load it right back. And we're going to go into free cam. There we go. So let's zoom out.
Okay, wow. Holy crap.
We'll take a quick spin around. There's the new guard tower. We're going to get to that in just a second. And there's the new interior of the courtyard.
My gosh.
I trust you're enjoying my company.
General Dave. And here's what the main entrance looks like from above out here. And you can actually see from above where the hole in the wall was. It's been totally filled in and sandbagged with defenses up top. The real built-up stuff, though, outside of, you know, that massive hole in the wall that was filled and then all the courtyard stuff, is back here in this corner. If you look at all of the staircases right there, all that was layered on top of piles of rubble, pretty much.
That is insane. Oh my god.
So, what we're going to do, I'm going to fire off the scrap all command. It's going to instantly scrap everything in the settlement so we can see basically what I started with. Like, there was a water purifier here, but there really was not much. And this will take a few seconds to fire off. I'm just going to hit it, and then we're going to wait.
What?
So...
Oh my gosh.
This is where all that concrete stairs and all were that I filled in.
Yeah, yeah.
And the reason it has so many layers to it was to cover each rise in the pile of rubble. Carefully and neatly.
Definitely covered every rise.
And back here, this had like a giant, basically ramp to get into the castle that is now totally fixed. This part of the wall, you can't even see that there was a hole here anymore because I used actual castle brick to seal it in. And this is the grand entranceway,
what was here originally. The guy's just like, I'm a badass.
Now,
that guy's swore.
One thing did not get scrapped. This concrete bunker is also not here, but this is actually, I think I built this with a very, very old mod back in like February. So it's kind of just like stuck here now. Yeah, like I can't scrap it anymore. But this is the communications bunker.
Wow.
And she is actually my communications lieutenant. Complete with a uniform to fit. So let's load up that save game and get back to it.
Oh my gosh.
And we are back. So going into free cam again, just briefly. Do you see now, Joel? See the gaps, like the little line in the stone
where I rebuilt the wall?
I kept it almost flush, just so you can tell where the repairs were. And
how long did that take, like, to do that?
It was a couple of episodes just building this section of the build videos. And if you notice, Joel, each layer of the steps goes up just enough to cover more of the debris.
Now I can see that.
There's just a tiny bit bleeding through right
cool.
there.
It honestly has a little of an Italian feel right here.
Like plazas and
Yeah. I like it.
Yeah.
It's really cool.
It's very, once again, opulent and fancy.
What I think is unique about this, Dave, which is really cool the way you build, is that it's not... It's like if you were to build super strict, like, you know, here's a straight line this.
Yeah, yeah.
Not having super straight lines everywhere makes it feel way more, I think, real and just like more fascinating to go explore, like look at, you know?
Yeah, yeah. And it's like kind of an in-between line between like apocalyptic building and like we put a lot of planning into it first. Like it's built with scrap, but it's very carefully built with scrap.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So before we check out the smaller barracks and stuff like that, Joel, you've been enjoying the posters, right, so far?
Yeah.
And you've been asking for months now through all these builds, like, where do all these freaking posters come from? Where do these giant General Dave flags and all come from? Well, a lot of them come from here at the castle, Joel. Let's go take a quick tour of the Department of Public Affairs.
I swear, you open it and it's about the children slaving away making pranks.
This is about the most Orwellian name that I could come up with for my propaganda center is what this is. So we're going to open it up. This is where, day and night, basically, we're printing Minutemen propaganda. This machine is down for some repairs, it looks like, but you can see some poster samples over here.
That doesn't stop them.
That's why we have two presses, plus additional facilities elsewhere. But this is where a lot of the propaganda is designed.
It's like, Dave, like that poster, it's like, oh man, it should be just like, we give you guys clean water, but it's just like, same way, clean water. It's just like, so like, all right, we'll do whatever you say, sir.
Because General Dave will never stop fighting.
Like a little teddy bear.
Yep, yep.
Save me.
This is the computer, the terminal, where they design some of the propaganda. Lots of files of old posters and notes and orders for new posters for different settlements.
What is that wrench for?
working on the machines, of
course.
Oh,
okay. Yeah. This is a smacking get back to work hammer.
And a fire extinguisher, because this is kind of a tight room full of paper. And you'll notice, Joel, that outside, it has this nice white brick, again, with more propaganda on the outside. But it also overlooks the outside of the castle. And you don't want the propaganda center taking, like, a direct rocket hit or something, right? It's up there on the wall. So notice the white brick outside. I actually rebuilt extra fortifications inside. I reinforced the inside walls with double-layer concrete to protect the propaganda center.
Oh my gosh.
And we've got some robots here working on the propaganda when Piper's
not
available.
That makes sense, because they'll never complain. They'll keep working forever.
Some of the posters that are being worked on. And a reminder how important it is for all of the good Minutemen to scrap everything.
Why is there so far? I'd slow it.
What's wild is this is an actual poster I found from World War II.
Really?
I think talking about how, like, to make all the guns and planes and tanks, everyone was supposed to, like, send their scrap materials to, like, the government to make guns and supplies for the war effort. But it fits in so well here, like, scrap everything. Never stop scrapping. And again, more posters over here in the corner being worked on with that low-hanging light to really get that detail right.
I can picture your General Dave character actually scrapping things himself, too. Like,
oh, yeah.
Like,
yeah.
It's like, sir, you need to look at these papers. It's like, I'm scrapping right now.
And, you know, with all the reinforced concrete and the tight quarters and all the printing, it gets pretty hot in there. So we're actually lucky enough to have our own air conditioning here at the Department of Public Affairs. You can see the AC unit right there. Now, you remember, Joel, we had the big chunk of the wall missing over there, where that small barracks now is.
Yeah.
But also the chunk of the wall missing right here, where you could basically walk up that pile of debris to get into the castle.
Remember that.
To help seal that in, what I actually did, one of our robot guards right there, Jezebel from the Automatron DLC, to help cover up that pile of rubble, I built a gigantic guard tower and then reinforced it on the corners with bits of steel. This lets us see everything from downtown all the way out to Pleasure Island there in the distance.
Wow.
And we can also see into the courtyard. If we peek at the edge, though, the main part of having that super tall tower is just to prevent people from being able to walk up that pile of debris and get over the wall.
Did you build that?
The robot?
No, in the distance. There's like a bus thing.
That's actually outside of the build zone.
Okay.
That's all us all here before. And attacks occasionally come from this little peninsula. So there's broadsider turrets on the side of the tower to watch over. They fire like cannonballs. Can't wait to try those out.
Oh, did you do that quest line with the pirate ship?
They're actually modded. I haven't gone to the Constitution
yet.
Still.
Okay. Oh my gosh.
I should, though.
It's a good quest.
Up here, we have a little patio where someone's drinking some moonshine. And even from this deck right here, we have a great view of the courtyard and all the guards walking around. He's actually pathfinding. Look at him go, Joel! He's pathbound through all the stairwells. I'm so happy!
I hope he just, like, floats up to the ceiling.
Woo-woo-woo! Manned artillery, of course, and turrets all around the castle.
Yeah.
We could shell the city into oblivion if we needed to. If we weren't kind overlords.
Hello, sir.
Man, he does not look like he messes around.
I like the concrete brick right there. That's like the one solid thing you can get behind.
Yeah, on purpose, you got a very solid bit of cover here. But can you imagine trying to attack with this tower overlooking everything, plus all the turrets attached to it? Like, we would see the attack coming as soon as they left the city, just instantly. Let's head on down the stairs here.
Woo! I can't imagine how many times you've just walked around.
Slow walked, of course.
Slow walked and just looked at everything that you've created.
These stairs right here are going to come down the side here. And I've actually built a custom railing because of that awkward gap. Don't want anybody falling while they're on guard duty. I'd have to build a railing for it.
Order is safety.
Order is safety. That's the Minutemen way. He just wiped the sweat off of his brow. That was awesome. It's like, oh, slaving away for the general.
That's exactly what he's doing, slaving away.
I'm going to take the access stairs here. This is the western wall.
Do you have names for, like, all these little areas, Dave?
In the back of my mind, yeah. Like, this is the western defensive wall right here. This is what overlooks the city. This is where that largest hole was right here. We've got guard stations. And to save on electricity, we have the machine gun turrets, which require no electricity. But if I go into free cam for a second, I'll show you on the outside of the wall. There's a heavy laser turret with bunting to decorate it, and even carefully organized wiring.
I was gonna say, like,
to make it look nice.
My gosh.
With spotlights, so in the event of an attack,
the lights will turn on, and
you can hit this switch right here.
Of course, there's a switch.
And all the spotlights come on, and the heavy laser turret spins up.
Like that boat, that was from someone probably sneaking in, and then he's dead. He's at the bottom of that.
Like, as if you needed extra turrets, you know? But I basically turned a hole in the wall into one of the most fortified walls. Tons of cover. We have these blast shields right here. So guards who are walking back and forth between all the guard stations have basically complete cover as they're traveling back and forth. And we're going to turn the corner here. You can see the courtyard and the main barracks. And we have an additional side barracks right here, also where the hole in the wall used to be. Got guards everywhere.
Get back to Diamond City.
Pretty cool looking rifle. Days.
Yeah, it's a plasma sniper rifle. Everyone here
makes me not want to play Fallout anymore. Because it's like, well, I don't have anything good like this. I don't have any of those weapons. I have no scrap. I have nothing.
You Fallout peasant. Joel, you should join the Minutemen. They're protecting your family.
Clean water, too.
Clean water and safety, as long as there's order. This is an additional barracks, just some overflow to help fill up some of that blank space where I rebuilt the wall. I just kind of nestled this...
Roller rumble. What's that?
It's like a rollerblading contest? I don't even know.
Dave, you need to build that now.
Again, just very clean, organized barracks.
Such magnificent paintings.
I love this painting. This is my favorite painting. One of my two favorites in the whole game. He's just like, yep, this is a cannon.
Yep, this is a cannon. This is cannon.
And shutters. Again, all the windows actually have working shutters. The hot spot's just hard to find. There we go. I'm going to turn around here. Bits of decoration, Nuka-Cola, a broom, and the umbrella stand. Got to keep things clean. And this leads right back out to the patios and up to the guard tower.
Oh, okay.
You see how it all comes together. This is like Dark Souls. You just come out and I know where I
am. Where's the bonfire?
Let's head down the stairs here. Again, railings for safety. Very nice marble and concrete. Can you imagine how many Brahmin we had to use to move all this concrete and marble over here? You call, we answer. With work,
for a price.
With work for you to do. That brings us to the armory / workshop. That little power armor shed was just like a courtyard work area.
Yeah, the cable goes through the concrete wall.
Yeah. Electricity goes through walls. That's how it works in real life.
Well, I mean, the cable, I guess you made a hole through it.
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, that's how it works.
It just looks like it's clipping to me. So I didn't see an actual hole.
Well, that's because you're not as experienced as I am with building Fallout. Okay. I believe you said that you don't have much scrap or any good weapons.
Yeah, yeah.
So trust the general.
Trust the general.
There's a hole. Inside here, order, safety, work together, and we can rebuild. Like all my builds, we have redundant power systems. So we have that generator right there. And if we duck back up here to the wall for a second, an extra solar panel up here. For extra power.
That was cool.
Let's go on back down here. Got a armor crafting workstation with some mats to protect it from the heat. The general is restoring hope.
I hate this place. I would never live here.
But you have to admit, Joel, if you could handle the order and the rules, wouldn't you feel safe living here? behind all this concrete and
turrets? I think I would rather face Deathclaws than this amount of order.
Protecting your family, Minutemen.
This is like Hunger Games style order. Like, like you will be happy because we told you.
We got some workstations here. Some makeshift
cleanliness
batteries.
Is happiness. It's awesome, though.
And welcome to my workshop. Inspired a bit by the title screen. George Washington behind the power armor. This is where we're working on the robots.
That's cool.
This thing takes up a ton of space. We have all the bits of circuitry and oil and
repair
stuff.
You add all that stuff in there, or does that come with it?
Oh, yeah, yeah. This room was almost empty. It had some shelves and like some of these mines and stuff like that were here. A little bit of pinup artwork, some ammo and storage containers, fire extinguishers for the robot workstation. And if we go back around here, we've got a fat man that someone's working on here on the table. Some keys, some ammo boxes, face paint fundamentals. And look, someone has been smoking back here. Cigarette in the ashtray. Tons of laser rifles, some additional traditional ammo here on the shelf. We've got ammo boxes. We've got our weapons workstation with a caution sign. Watch out for the explosive materials. And this being a workshop, it's got some of the old tin, you know, the red rocket, stuff like that. Reminder to scrap everything. And then our main storage for the armory. We've got weapons, we've got supplies, we've got mini nukes. A whole crate of mini nukes from Fort Strong. Caution, hazardous material. Warning about hearing protection. And this is our primary...
So Turquoise like, hands like, I give you robots.
We're working on some of that, I think it's the X-01 power armor.
Maybe you need to replace his face with your General Day face.
It's just like a cutout, like on George Washington's face of my character's
face.
Oh,
dude, you should get one of those things where it has a cutout of your face and people can be General Day, like take photos.
Oh, that's not allowed.
I guess it'd be mocking.
Yeah, that's not allowed
then
at all.
Then that goes to Pleasure Island.
Be the General for a day stand. All kinds of tools and bits of scrap and all from everything being worked on back here. But yeah, this was kind of inspired by the title screen, just that kind of homey feeling workshop. Organized, but also a little bit cluttered.
Oh my gosh.
Let's head on out of the armory. And we're gonna go across the courtyard here and take the access stairs up to the rooftop and check out some of the stuff on the roof. Let's just go up this way.
Yeah, this is the entrance. This is above the entrance, right?
This is the main grand entrance. There's the deck down there. And all that we've really missed back here, besides some carefully set up stairs tucked into all the corners here. It took forever to line all that up.
Yeah.
There's the western wall that we came across.
Okay.
And this mortar right here is generally not manned. It's closer to the city. It's not really needed. We have two manned at all times. But in case of heavy attack, we can man it if we need to. And some decorative old-style cannons from the fort. I believe, yep, he's on guard up here. I think he's got that like level 5 railroad like armor plating. That stuff is heavy duty. With the Minuteman hat. And if you remember this, Joel, the access door. If I can hit it, there we go. For quick access down.
Like I would leave that open every once in a while, and it's dark, and they're like, step back.
Well, notice all the safety rails. And now, Joel, you know me. I can't have anything floating. This deck is actually a second deck on top of the roof for the grand entranceway. So I use cinder blocks to actually prop the deck up. As you're coming up the stairs here, you actually can see underneath. So it couldn't just be floating. I had to prop it up correctly with concrete. Man. And there's just looking across at the tower.
Like, do you make sure any steps or anything that you can walk up very smoothly? You don't ever have to jump or anything?
Yes. Also for the NPCs, because they get stuck on everything, even in the base game. And this is where Preston Garvey is assigned.
He's got a standing mat, too. I like that.
Notice where he's standing, too, over the grand entranceway. With the statue out front. Look at the two of us, Joel. Retaking the Commonwealth for the good of the Minutemen.
Dude, I hate that guy. That was always like, here's another thing to do. I'm like, shut up! That wasn't you whistling.
And we have a radio for quick communication from up here, just in case we need it. And you can't actually put your settlers inside of power armor, but this power armor is ready to go, and in case of an attack, they may actually use it. So it's ready to be used. But to save on, you know, fusion cores, it's just here on standby. I love that texture. It looks awesome.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
The guy did a great job on that mod.
It's kind of like a blue stone.
Yeah. Yeah, it has just the right amount of wear. And over here we've got additional turrets. That guy, look at him, he's straddling that cannon. Look at that. Dude, that's awesome. He's thrusting at the Commonwealth. Oh, that's amazing.
Minutemen will shoot their cannons at you.
Oh, we have additional manned mortars back here. And this is actually a plasma turret that is overlooking the original water purifier. Man. That thing looks nasty. Like, look at the copper tip on that. This little entranceway right here leads down to the bar area. But we'll come back
around.
Yeah, there's a bar. Yeah, there's a full bar. But we're going to come back around to that. We're going to keep going along the wall for now. Got some farming going on up here. Kind of in the same vein as the water purifier, like the water well that's inside the wall. We want enough food and water to be able to basically survive for months, if need be, inside of the castle with no contact. So we have some mute fruit trees just down the back of the wall here so that as you're harvesting them, you won't get shot from down below.
Yes.
Notice how many guards, too, we have constantly watching
another
the ocean.
Day of hard work.
This castle fell once. It's never going to fall again.
Because you weren't running it.
Now, for the main quest, I chose the Minutemen and the Railroad as my factions. So this is the vertibird that we stole from the Brotherhood of Steel.
Oh, that's cool.
It's now my personal vertibird. And you guys might actually see some Minutemen vertibirds show up in later settlement tours. So keep an eye out for those. I've got some mods in the works. It's kind of a precarious landing spot. Like, it's a nice big concrete pad. But man, like, you have to really watch those propellers and get it on this tiny little landing pad. Well, I guess the landing pad is not tiny, it's just that the vertibird is massive. So we have some very skilled pilots. Now, for our additional farm fields here, notice we have a concrete
wall. Freaking propaganda, really, like, right behind the corner.
To help protect the farmers, we have additional defensive walls so that even rockets or grenades can't be tossed up at the farmers. And you can see down the back wall right here. And this chimney actually comes from my quarters, my personal quarters. So just remember the chimney.
Okay.
We'll come back around to that. Lots and lots of farming going on. But even our farmers are wearing their berets and their Minutemen uniforms. And protective goggles. I actually added the farming, like, plots of land up here, too. Because the dirt's not super thick up here.
Yeah.
So to actually allow roots to take hold, we brought in dirt. Again, those poor Brahmin hauling all this crap.
Smash the prostitution rep.
And that guy's going deep for that corn. Order is safety, work together, and we can rebuild.
Oh, you should change it. We will rebuild.
Crop's been growing pretty
good. We're going to rebuild. Don't you worry. Because General Dave will never stop fighting. And turrets watching Pleasure Island.
Oh, okay, that is Pleasure Island. Okay.
Yep. General Dave is always watching.
Every time you go into Pleasure Island. Third person. Like your little thing.
Oh, that's on purpose.
Yeah, it ripples a little bit.
A little ruffle. I'm just going to duck a little bit back over here to tie in where we were earlier. And also, I'm not sure if you saw this banner earlier, but big one over that door down there, the general is restoring hope next to the propaganda stage. And notice the clock and the flag in the courtyard. Gotta remember whose shift it is. No slacking here at the castle.
Or you will be reminded. Only once.
Let's head on over here where we actually have a...
This.
We have a security gate for the cell block. Now, the castle is not the prison, right? Red Rocket is the holding area. There's no actual prison build, at least not yet. But we do have holding cells, maybe for discipline for the Minutemen, or for maybe like a spy tries to get in.
Question for the, for this thing.
Yeah.
Are you not allowed to center that text?
The mod that I am using just did not have it centered. I just rolled with it.
Okay. I was just wondering if it was like a choice or that you kind of had to only go with it.
I could have centered it, but I kind of like it. It's like a street sign kind of okay. style. Yeah. And notice nothing's allowed to float. I added steel supports for the iron gate on each side of the door because it like wasn't quite connecting width-wise. But I love the shadows, too, from the door. It looks awesome. Those, like, soft shadows. That iron security gate leads down into the bowels of the castle itself, where we have a very secure two-cell holding area. And this is where the prisoners are kept, or people who are being disciplined.
Like high-security, like, people you're taking.
Yeah, yeah. If they're being maybe held for questioning, they'll be taken over to Red Rocket soon. So Inquisitor Joel can speak with them.
the Dark Deeds. Although you guys are starting to turn into the Dark Deeds.
But remember,
it looks all happy.
Let's not forget, Joel, we're providing Sanctuary, Croup Manor, all these nice places for the Commonwealth. There's a price to pay.
Yes, there is.
And someone smuggled in a comic book, Robco Fun. That's our holding cells. And these actually worked really well to just clip right into that nice, like, rounded ceiling. Very high ceiling cells. And to go along with holding cells, oh, look at that, he's actually on station right now.
That's awesome.
Even with no prisoners. Oh, dude, this guy is my rocketeer. Notice the helmet and the blast shield? He's got, like, a triple barrel rocket launcher. So he's pretty hardcore. He's got that vault tech security. So yeah, all the guard armor is, like, a mixture of Minutemen and Railroad. You've got someone's been reading a book on guard. You got a camera for taking photos of the prisoners and some lockers for storage and some first aid for the prisoners as well. So we're gonna come out right here. And you can see we have the very secure cell block entrance right there.
Going into the medieval section, the Beauty and the Beast room.
This is where the opulence really starts kicking in, Joel. Welcome to the interior of the castle. That way leads out to the parade field, but we're actually going to start right here at General Dave's conference room, the very carefully wood-burned sign to welcome visitors to the conference room.